The Derby Bucks story in 1993-94 doesn't start in a sports centre. In fact, it nearly didn't start at all. The club was short of a major sponsor, and they'd even gone as far as to tell the Basketball League to take their name off this season's fixture list. But then, More Windows, based here at Station Road in Micklover, came in with a very late and rather dramatic rescue package. So, why does a football fan who's never seen a basketball game want to put money into the Bucks?
Purely and simply, on a commercial venture. We want to get the name of More Windows over to members of the Derby public in a different vein than normal papers, where we're putting adverts out every week and everybody sees the adverts and we're just another number of double glazing companies. So therefore, by putting the name of More Windows in front of the Derby Bucks, we hope that the name will get mentioned more.
How did you hear that the Bucks were in financial trouble?
I heard it on Radio Derby. I was coming back to the office and I heard a person asking for help. So we rang up the Radio Derby to get the telephone number of this particular person. We went from there.
Well then, Jeff, what do you expect to see when you actually go to watch your first basketball game?
Well, I hope to get excitement more than what I've seen in Derby County the last 2 years. There's been no effort, I feel, in terms of commitment from Derby County players, and I hope that there'll be more commitment from the Derby Bucks players.
September the 19th, 1993, and the Bucks' first Budweiser League game of the season away to last year's promoted champions, Doncaster Panthers. Several new players in the Bucks lineup. There's number 14, Andy Gardner, who's come back to this country after 4 years' absence. 13 is Jason Seaman, one of the two new Americans in the side. Tim Lascelles back for his eighth season with the club. And there, 15, you just saw Charlie Mant in the edge of the picture. He's the second new American. Seaman taking the tip with Carl Mitchell, number 15 there for Doncaster, the former Bucks centre. And it's Ian McKinney, the England under 23 point guard and Loughborough University student, on the point for the Bucks. Mant dishes off to Lascelles, goes for a three-pointer, misses. Gardner, great rebound there, and draws the foul on Carl Mitchell. So, Derby immediately onto the offence. Gardner doing a good job in drawing that foul. But a little bit tense at the start of the game, missing with the first free throw. Gardner at Hawaii Pacific University, where he helped them to a championship, missing the second one as well. And it's Doncaster in possession. Stedroy Baker at the court to the Panthers' new American. That's Anthony Joseph, but Doncaster can't find the net either. McKinney finds Mant off the glass for the first points of the season. Now we rejoin the game later on in the first quarter. In fact, with 5 minutes of the first half remaining, and Ronnie Baker doing a good job there, gets the bucket and the foul, so he's going to go to the line for the bonus. Score at the moment is 35 all. Doncaster looking very lively in the initial stages, and Derby getting in a little bit of foul trouble with Jason Seaman picking up early fouls. Not quite used to the play yet over here, but that's a big rebound from Andy Gardner. Andy Mayer on as a substitute for Tim Lascelles. Ian McKinney, good turn there. Mayer, and nails the three. Mayer in his ninth season with the Bucks. That's a superb shot. And there's Carl Mitchell trying to get the ball, loses out to Seaman. Just some good D from Derby at the moment. Mayer trying to find Seaman, but there's a hand on that one. It's Joseph Baker up the court. And the Panthers slowing it down. Mitchell coming inside and scoring there. A typical Carl Mitchell basket, penetrating inside the keyway, and the high shot which drops in. Mayer for Derby. McKinney has got Baker all over him there. That looked like a foul, but the referee says it's a travelling violation. And Charlie Mant showing his displeasure with that decision. Baker still in possession. Barrett, that shot's no good. Good rebound from Mant, and Andy Gardner clears the boards. Down at the other end, Gardner. Excellent 2 points already. Gardner making his presence felt in the Bucks lineup. Again, Gardner. He's having such an impressive first half for the Bucks. Mant also looking a bit useful, and what a reverse layup that was. Well, Derby beginning to pull away now. This is their best spell of this first game of the season. And Doncaster might have had a lot of victories in the second division, but certainly finding the transition to the Budweiser League a little bit tough. Mant finds Mayer. Good pass to Seaman. Can't get around Mitchell that time. But Mayer knocks it back. McKinney, nice little fake. The shot won't go down. And the rebound there. And the foul is given against Gardner. Substitution for Doncaster, and here comes Derek Iseline. Now you may remember that he was at Derby back in January. Didn't do very much at all for the Bucks. Didn't manage to add anything on offence. In fact, he scored just 2 points in 7 outings for the Bucks. But here he is coming off the bench for Doncaster. Baker looking to get past Mayer. This is good defence from Derby at the moment. And that's a three-pointer that misses. Seaman pulls down the rebound. Straight down to the other end. Oh! Well, he could have been called for a travelling violation there. He wasn't. And he scores. And Seaman again clearing the boards. A few problems here. Baker lashing out. And there could be a few ugly scenes here. Andy Mayer acting as peacemaker. Terry Mangum there as well, just saying calm it all down and asking the referee what he's going to do about that. Well, that was clearly Baker going in and kicking Seaman while they were on the deck. And in fact, it's called an intentional foul. Seaman on the line. He made both free throws, and here he is shortly after on the line again. And puts that one away. Derby really stretching their lead at the moment. This is a good performance by the Bucks, their first game of the season. These players have only known each other for a couple of weeks, and they're putting together some good stuff in their first Budweiser League game of the season. Terry Mangum with the steal. Superb job. Straight down the other end. Well, he wants the foul there on Andrew Barrett, but doesn't get it. Ball knocked away from him, but it's going to be Derby sideline possession. Mant with a fake. The ball won't drop, and that's another foul called. These two referees very experienced and calling quite a few fouls there. That one's on the defensive end. So Terry Mangum going to the line to shoot 1-1. First one's good. As is the second, so all the shooting in practice pays off there for the player coach. And Derby doing just as good a job with Terry Mangum, Andy Mayer and Andy Bird on the court as they did with their starting five. Another three-point attempt falls short. Mayer with the rebound that time. Come on, Mangum, that's a good pass inside to Seaman, fighting off the defence and off the glass for two more points. And tremendous defence. That's going to be Derby's possession on the side. They really have stepped up the defensive intensity in this second quarter. Pass from Mangum to Mant. So to the side to Andy Bird. Mayer. Right on the half-time buzzer. Brilliant second quarter for the Bucks there. Gives them quite an astonishing advantage at half-time. Early in the second half now, Derby leading 58-41. As Doncaster in possession. That one won't count for Tim Lascelles, the foul committed before he actually took the shot. And Charlie Mant with a three-pointer. And that's Mitchell clearing out Seaman, and he's called for the charge. Good refereeing there. Mitchell going in with his elbow. So that'll be Derby's possession. What can Lascelles do with this one? Mand, what a bucket that was. 63-43. Derby really putting together an impressive performance in the first game of the season. Much more disciplined than Doncaster. Really having difficulties getting back into this game. There's Mitchell though. Puts two more in. Not been the offensive threat that Doncaster would have liked though. Here's Lascelles. This is with a three-pointer though. And no foul called there. Well, fortunately for Derby, they got possession. That looked like a charge, but it wasn't given. And the coach, Terry Mangum, calling the play from the sideline. Great pass inside to Andy Gardner, holds it superbly and puts the ball in. Derby's lead getting ever bigger. Now we rejoin the game, 7 minutes to go. Derby leading by 84 points to 70. Oh, lovely unselfish basketball there. Great pass from Mangum to Jason Seaman. Mitchell doing a good job that time, but basically he's come out second best against Seaman this evening. McKinney, who's looked quite impressive first game of the season. And there goes Mant in, dunks the ball that time after Seaman dishes off to him. And again, Derby step up the defensive intensity. Fantastic long pass there from Terry Mangum, that's one of his specialities. And Ian McKinney gets the points. Iselin handling the ball well there, better than he did at Derby. And Mitchell gets the foul in his favour on that occasion. Lascelles, wonderful rebound. Well, he's always been known as a leaper and he certainly got up high for that one. Gardner double-teamed, but it's still Derby's possession. Mant. Oh, slashing his way to the hoop and the finger roll as well. That's excellent basketball from Charlie Mant. Derby well on top now. There's McKinney, and he celebrates the first victory of the season for the Bucks. And very well deserved it was too. Celebrations for the Bucks there, a really good performance, better than anyone could have hoped in their first game.
A very good start to the season. Everybody was working hard. Even when we were up 20, we didn't stop working. Even though we lost the ball a couple times, we didn't take care of the ball as much as I thought we could have. But everybody just gave it 100% today, and we were able to take the game.
What do you think the difference was then between Derby and Doncaster?
We just out-hustled them. We didn't give them any second shots, and we got a lot of second shots, and we converted on the second shots, and we were just hitting the glass. And we got our hands on a lot of loose balls. We just out-hustled them tonight.
They seemed a little bit disappointing, particularly their American Carl Mitchell, who used to play for Derby.
Right. I think they were probably disappointed because they underestimated our ability. Basically, you know, we ranked fifth. I'm not sure what they were ranked. What were they ranked?
They were champions of the Division Two last year.
Yeah, see, they were champions, and we were ranked fifth. And we come in and just run them off the court. You got to be a little disappointed. I don't feel sorry for them, though.
You must be looking forward to the first game at home on Thursday against Hemel Hempstead.
Oh, I can't wait till we get home. I'm always looking forward to play, because when you got a team that works as hard as we do, it's always a good time.
4 days later, the Bucks were back at home, the first game of the season at Moorways against one of last season's strugglers, Hemel Hempstead Royals, and the chance for the new team to be introduced to the crowd. Ian McKinney leads them out, number 5, followed by one of the old favourites, Tim Lascelles. There's Andy Bird, one of 3 Loughborough University students this season. Andy Mayer, one of the longest serving stalwarts of the club. Nigel Fisher, back for his second year with the Bucks. Rob Stevenson from Loughborough, known for his shooting ability. And then in his 10th season in British basketball, the player coach, Terry Mangan. Jason Seaman, recommended to the club, in fact, by former player coach Nick Nurse. Andy Gardner of Bracknell 4 years ago, but this is his first time back in this country. And from Grand Valley State University, Charlie Mant. So, the game underway. And Mant, what a start. First game in front of the Moorways crowd, and that'll win him plenty of fans, that will. Hemel have brought in a couple of Americans to add to the team that struggled last year. There's one of them, Derek Dennison, getting an early basket. Seaman trying to find space inside the shot, but it's no good. And Derby, in fact, struggling quite a lot in the early stages. They didn't play with the intensity that people expected of them. And the crowd rather slow to get in the game. There were one or two very good moves, though, including this one. McKinney behind the back. And Charlie Mant puts it in. Lascelles dishes off to Jason Seaman. Slams that one in. Well, Seaman known as a dunker. That's the sort of thing we can expect. And he's gonna, that's Charlie Mann taking the charge. Excellent defensive work. Stood his ground and the offensive charge caught against Hemel. And this time, dishes off to Seaman, dunks again, but the referee blows his whistle. What's he going to call here? He's given a technical against him, swinging on the ring. Now that one not going down very well with the crowd. Still in the third quarter, Derby trailing 61-46. What can they do to get back into this game? But there's a good rebound from Tim Lascelles, going coast to coast, and puts it in. Excellent play by Tim Lascelles. And will that spark the crowd off? Can they get into the game and really get behind the Bucks at the moment? Leon Noel for the Royals. Jody John, shot, that's no good. Picked up by Charlie Mant. McKinney, Lascelles. Try for the three-pointer, it's no good though. Jody John with the rebound. Hemel coming quickly up court with Dennison. Back to Noel. John trying to come inside. Doesn't get there. Three-pointer is no good, but Hemel pick up the rebound. Noel with the three-pointer. Doesn't get there. Good skill from Mant. Terry Mangum. Andy Gardner trailing. Excellent basket. This could well be Derby's best spell of the game so far, in fact. They've really not put their game together at all as they did at Doncaster on Sunday. There's McKinney. Just gets away with that. Hemel wanting a travel. And there's Gardner again. Picking up the pieces with the easy layup, Andy Gardner. Tony Peltier and turning the ball over, Charlie Mant trying to get the crowd going. Is Derby really fighting their way back at the moment? Mant, great turn, but the shot misses. And one of the smallest men on the court there, getting the rebound. That's Keith Pringle for Hemel. Another three-point attempt misses and Terry Mangum is fouled. Quite a few fouls being called against Hemel at the moment. Andy Mayer wanting to get into the action, but referee being a little bit pedantic there, won't let him come in until he's made all the signals. McKinney with Gardner coming over for the screen, and the pick and roll gets the pass from Mangum and scores again. Andy Gardner having a very impressive time at the moment, contributing quite a lot of the Bucks' points as they're beginning to make a fight of it. Dennison, there's no way through there. Mant couldn't get hold of that one. Still going to be Hemel's possession from the side. With Jody John to inbound the ball. The time running out though. They need to get a shot off pretty quickly. And too late. That's a 30-second violation. Tremendous defensive play by Derby. And they've prevented Hemel from scoring for quite some time now. Mangum into Gardner again. He's causing all sorts of problems inside, but that one won't count. It's the foul committed beforehand by Jody John. Hemel not in the team penalty at the moment, so it's sideline possession. Andy Mayer comes round and gets the three-pointer off the screen there. Superb shot from Mayer. And that takes Derby to an 11-0 run. Really making a fight of it now, the Bucks. As Andrew Ayrault, one of Hemel's Americans, gets a couple for the visitors. Mant, good pass, Manga misses, but there's Gardner again. The garbage man gets in 2 points there. The second attempt. And that's the sort of play you need when your shots aren't going in at the first try. Inside the last 5 minutes, Derby still trailing by 73 points to 67, but there's Tim Lascelles, fakes the three-pointer and drives through. And good D by the Bucks, Lascelles again. This time Charlie Mant trailing, but he's called for the charge. And Vince Razak, the Hemel coach, particularly happy about that one. It's been a spirited fight back by the Bucks, but still, things not going exactly as they'd want. It's getting a little bit tense out there now. It seems as though it's going to be the team who've got the coolest heads. In the last few minutes, we're going to come out on top. Mark Carty can't get that one to drop though. Quick break from the Bucks. Mangum to McKinney. And McKinney nails it, and he's delighted with that. Because that means the Bucks are trailing by just one, 73-72. And we're inside the last 3 minutes. Leon Noel trying to find a way through. That's a terrific shot. With two. So Hemel leading by three. Tim Lascelles losing his feet on the court there and stabs his foot on the ball, so Derby going to lose possession. Hemel passing it around into the three-pointer. They didn't really need that at this stage of the game. And that's a foul. They didn't want that either. Because Jody John has fouled out. That's his fifth. Well, Hemel could have done with him in their lineup for the last couple of minutes, but he's going to sit on the bench and take no further part in this game. And Tony Peltier comes back into the action to replace him. Terry Mangum on the line. Derby really could have done with that, although Gardner gets the rebound. Lascelles, the long-range shot, misses. And Hemel on the break. Dennison, a quick spin and puts it in. So that takes the lead up to 5. And less than 2 minutes to play. Now the Bucks need a couple of big plays here. Going to that man, Andy Gardner. The first shot misses, takes his own rebound. And again, third time lucky, Gardner scores. Tremendous determination there from Andy Gardner. The Bucks then still trailing by 3. Oh, Terry Mangum almost stealing that one. And it's given Derby's ball. The tension almost unbearable now. Derby again going to Gardner. The shot misses though. And great hustle by Terry Mangum. McKinney finds Gardner, fouled as he puts that one in. 3-point opportunity here for the Bucks. Trailing 77-76. Inside the last minute. Gardner makes it. The pressure on him there, but that was no problem. Ties the game at 77-all. Carty trying to find a pass inside. Everyone scrambling around for that one. Which way's it gone? It's Hamill ball. Surely they'll take the time here and try to get off a good shot. They do, but Tim Lascelles rejects it. Still going to be Hemel with possession. Dennison trying to go through there, but an excellent block by Lascelles. And the shot clock is reset, although there's less than 30 seconds to go. But it means Hemel can hang on and run down the clock, but they don't. They take a very early shot. And Gardner is pushed in the back by Peltier. And the referee confirming that. Number 10, Tony Peltier. And he lost his head a little bit there, because that's put Andy Gardner on the line with just 9 seconds remaining. So after being 16 points down, the Bucks get themselves into a position where they can win it. Andy Gardner on the line for the 1-1. That's put the Bucks into the lead for the first time since the opening minutes of the game. 78-77. And there's still so much tension out there. It could still go either way. He misses the second one, does Gardner. 9 seconds on the clock. And that's a steal. And a travelling violation. So the Bucks getting possession. That's virtually the last play of the game. And unless Derby do something absolutely stupid now, they're going to get their second victory of the season. Well, who would have thought it after some of the early play when Derby were so far behind. And there's the final buzzer. Two games, two victories for the Bucks. Andy, you really made hard work of that one.
Yeah, we did. We came out kind of slow in the first quarter, well, the first half period. And, you know, our big guys got in the foul trouble, me included. So the bench came in, they done a good job. You know, we didn't lose anything. We may have lost out on the balls, but, you know, we came back hard in the third quarter and we sucked it up and went for the fourth quarter. We got the win.
What was going through your mind when you went to the line for those free throws right at the end?
Well, it was I had to forget my three other misses, and it was like, you know, in the fourth quarter, and you've got to like put them away when you get the chance, and I was just concentrating on my follow through and looking at the back of the rim.
And then you went down the other end on defense and got a valuable hand on the ball.
Oh, well, to be honest, it wasn't my hand. It was Tim Lestove made that steal. I was just standing in front. It may look like I got it, but it wasn't me. I was scared to put my hand there. I may have got the foul, so I didn't do nothing. But thanks to Tim, yeah, he got the steal, so that was good.
Good start for you. Two victories in two games.
Yeah, we're going well, you know. We're making hard work of it, but we're getting a win, so that's what counts, you know. As long as the crowd's happy, we're all right.
There was a lot of pressure on us to perform and beat what we thought was a weaker team. I think, personally, there wasn't as much pressure as the game on Sunday, but there was still intense out there.
What did Terry Mangum say to you at half-time when you were trailing by quite a few points?
I think he said the right thing. We weren't being outplayed particularly, we were just being out-hustled. The odd loose ball was going to them, the odd rebound, you know, they were getting offensive boards, and just scrambling every loose ball seemed to go to them. I think that's where we lost. You know, that's why with the points down we were at half-time. And I think in the second half we just hustled a lot more and played certainly a lot harder defence and managed to shut them out a lot more.
Even so, a very tense ending.
Oh, definitely. I think it'll take a while to sink in the actual result, but it's a win no matter how we get it, so that's 2-0 now. I think we're certainly pleased with the record, if not the whole performance today.
For the final game of September, the Bucks going to Granby Halls to come up against their old rivals, Leicester Riders. Now, games between these two clubs, normally very hard-fought affairs, and this one, yet another dogfight. Leicester leading at this particular point by 8-5 early in the first quarter. Seaman pulls down the rebound there as Errol Rowe went to the line. Seaman straight down the other end with the bucket and fouled by number 15, Gord Wood, one of the two foreigners in the Leicester team. And Seaman makes the bonus. Derby have had some memorable victories at Granby Halls over the years. Will this be another one? Lascelles with the steal finds Ian McKinney. And Terry Mangum called for a travelling violation. Rather unusual. Gene Waldron on the point for Leicester. The man who in fact could come between the Bucks and victory, but not if he passes like that all night. A little bit of a misunderstanding there, throwing that one out of bounds, but he's been in good form already this season, has Waldron. One man who Derby will certainly have to watch as the game progresses. Derby getting into early foul trouble again. You'll notice that Mangum and Andy Bird into the action early on. Bird will be happy with that, scoring against his old club. Waldron faced there by Lascelles. Leicester trying to work the ball around. Dylan Bogg with a three-point attempt. Doesn't go down, and it's out of bounds, Derby's possession. McKinney to Andy Gardner. That shot's no good, and it's rebounded by 14, Hilroy Thomas, another of the newcomers in the Leicester team this season. Waldron thinking about going all the way himself, and he picks up the foul. So Waldron on the line, and you can tell that one was good. The second one not though. Lascelles with one of his speciality defensive rebounds. Derby in the lead at the moment, 10-9. Maldon, though, with the steal from Lascelles, straight down the other end. And Leicester edge in front. That was a very good fast break from the box. Andy Bird fouled, so he'll go to the line. Several fouls in the early stages of this game, just as there were in the Hemel and Doncaster games, in fact. Bird coolly putting the first one away. And the second as well. So the small forward from Burton on Trent making a good impression here at the Granby Halls. And that's a charge. Caught against David Mills. Good job by Terry Mangan. Stood his ground well. Bird. Can't hold that one though. It's Leicester on the break. Waldron finds Bogg, puts it back to Dave Harris. And the veteran of the Leicester side scores to make it 13-12. Lead changing hands quite a lot in the opening stages. Bird going for the long range effort there, comes up short. And Mangan with the steal. McKinney. The contact with Waldron is not called a foul, and Tim Lascelles scores. Must be a little bit angry about that one. There was certainly contact between McKinney and Waldron, but the referee said, carry on. Quick pass inside, it's picked off. Mangan, and that's picked off as well by Waldron. Well, play getting a little bit scrappy at the moment. Several turnovers by both teams. McKinney to Mangan. Lascelles. Well, he still can't connect with the three-pointer. Harris for Leicester. Ooh, excellent skill. And Waldron will calm it down and set up the next offence. That one's slipping out of his hand. But he steals it back from Gardner. And a knee brought up into the chest there, and the referee's given nothing. Well, that was certainly a foul on Terry Mangan. And it was justice that Leicester didn't score from that. Down the other end, Lascelles. And he makes it. That's his first three-pointer of the new season. And he's put Derby back into the lead, 17-15. Well, Leicester going inside there, getting the foul. Errol Rowe on the line. Missed the first one but scored the second. There's Gardner straight down the other end for the Bucks. He's made a terrific start to the season as Gardner, and he's continuing to impress this evening. Gets a hand on that, and Lascelles eventually pushes the ball through to McKinney. Mangan finds Andy Bird again, and Bird really doing well against his old team. 21-16 at the moment, the Bucks leading in the second quarter. Gardner again getting a hand on that one, but Terry Mangan almost lost it to Gord Wood, but in fact his foot went over the halfway line. It's a backcourt violation, so Derby will have possession. Mangan inside to Gardner. Gets the shot, looked as though he was fouled, doesn't get it called. And again going in. Yet again, Andy Gardner. The third time of asking, puts the ball through the hoop, just as he did against Hemel. No real pattern to this game though. The lead has changed hands quite a few times in the first half. In fact, no fewer than 13. Tim Lascelles with the breakaway. Two more points for Tim. Well, that was Rowe going for the dunk. Missed it, in fact. And Gardner on the break for the Bucks. Charlie Mantan, that's the way to dunk. Is it going to be called for a technical there for hanging onto the ring? No, the referee has a word with him, gives the 2 points, and just says, take it easy. The start of the third quarter then. Tim Lascelles going straight through and levelling it up at 41 all. The lead changing hands no fewer than 13 times altogether in this game. Neither side able to put together a good run, although Bogg, faking the three-pointer, puts the ball inside, and that's Errol Rowe, who gives Leicester a 2-point lead again. And McKinney trying to find someone under the basket, but throws that one out of bounds. Bogg, faced by McKinney, to Harris, Waldron, dishes off there, and that man Gardner again with the rebound. They'll be trying to break quickly. It's Mant, comes inside, the shot's no good, it's rebounded by Errol Rowe. Neither side able to stamp their superiority on this game. It's good defence by Charlie Mant. Harris trying to come inside. The shot is short. Lascelles gets a hand on it. McKinney driving through. Gets the points and is fouled. Superb job by Ian McKinney. And the youngster going to the line for the bonus. And puts it in to give Derby the lead again. By 44 points to 43. And could this be the stage when Derby really do start to control the tempo? Lascelles can't connect. McKinney picks up the loose one. He can't score either. David Mills bringing that up to Dylan Bogg. Leicester finding difficulty getting through the Derby defence. Lascelles getting his hand on that but couldn't keep his feet. Bit of contact there, but the referee lets it go. This is Steve Walker, number 4. Time running out, and McKinney gets a hand on it. Derby with the fast break, and Tim Lascelles scores again. From then on, the Bucks never loosened their grip on the game. They always came up with the big plays, and Leicester got into foul trouble. Derby shooting 23 from 33 free throws. The final score, 84-77.
Entirely different from last season. If we had the team here that was here last season, we wouldn't have won that game. But the team this year is showing a lot of pride and determination when it really counts.
It must be a very unusual position for you to be in at the top of the league, although it's only early days.
like you said, it's early days, and I don't want to go on about it, but I can remember one season here, my early seasons here, that we started out about 5-0, 6-0, and the season turned around in the end because of injuries and players not playing up to par. So I don't want to brag too much about being on top of the league right now.
Nevertheless, it's been a good start for you. 3 matches, 3 victories.
Very good start. We've beaten teams that we should beat if we want to be up there in the top 4 or 5 at the end of the season. We're beating teams that we need to beat. These are must games if we want to be in contention of any trophies this season.
And the best is yet to come.
Yeah, we'll be tested very much this weekend coming with Cheshire and Manchester.
You're hopeful that you can do as well, though, if not better than last season?
Yeah, I'd like to do a lot better than last season. It's going to take a lot of more work. Like I said, it's early days, but I think this team can do it.
3 games, 3 victories then for the Bucks, and what a transformation. 8 weeks ago, they almost went out of business. Now they're top of the league, and it does get better. Join us next month for some amazing basketball. These are just some of the highlights from the Chester game.